I realize that my channel is all about things you can do within QuickBooks and a little side of other software. I just thought I'd take a moment and run through different softwares that are fairly common that small businesses may choose to use for their business bookkeeping. I do have experience with these other softwares, but I only teach QuickBooks. So if anything looks good and you want a resource to help you, feel free to let me know, and I'll just ask in my network to see if anybody does use the software, teach the software, provide bookkeeping services for the software. If there's anything you'd like to see me do a slightly deeper dive on, I'm happy to, with the caveat that I'm not going to support or teach anything really beyond QuickBooks, but I'm happy to put together like a 3 to 5 minute video on something. Okay, so the first one up on the list is Xero. I just pulled up their pricing page so you can see what the price ranges are. Recognize that every time you see a price, this is the introductory price. And so you have to do the math to figure out, say $54 over 3 months, like what would it be? The answer, usually 20, usually 47, usually 80. You can run through here and see what each edition covers and what might make sense for you. I think a good thing to do whenever you're considering a different software is to look at images, look at videos. You're not looking at these to see, oh, do I understand how to use the software? You're looking at them to see, do I like the way that it looks? Does it make my gut clench up? And do I think to myself, no, this is not my style. Think of it kind of like how when you're looking for a different to-do list or project management software, you're going to look at some images until you find something that you think, I want to learn more about that. That's what I would encourage you to do with these. So here's the Xero dashboard. The Xero dashboard is kind of where you land when you first open the program. So you get like some graphs and some watch lists. Your account watch list are accounts that you specify to put there, which I like that a lot. And then just some other useful stuff. Here's some other graphs that you get. So this is telling you, checking account, there's 29 things to deal with, your watch list, your invoices. I would just encourage you to click around, and if what you click into looks good, then go to YouTube and watch some videos. Again, the point is not to learn how to use the software. The point is to decide, would you enjoy learning how to use the software? Or would you enjoy having your accounting records in this software? The next software is QuickBooks. QuickBooks, I'm just going to flip this over so you can see the regular pricing. Here it is. I help people use QuickBooks. I do things for them, like catch them up and fix it and hand it back. I also do ongoing bookkeeping. If you want to know about QuickBooks, I have plenty of videos on my channel. Let me just pull up some images for you. This is what you see when you log into your QuickBooks. Well, this is what you used to see. It looks somewhat like this. Intuit or QuickBooks is frequently updating what it looks like when you log in. So you're going to see something that's similar to this or similar to that. Just, you know, take a look at some images. If you're not currently using QuickBooks, look around and see how it feels. All of these that I'm providing you like slight information for, they're all going to be software that's popular enough that you'll be able to find someone who can help you use it. So I don't want you to look at this and say, oh, I have to use QuickBooks because that's the one I've heard of. Like, I can assure you these others are popular enough that people do use them and they have heard of them. The next one is FreshBooks. And I was just looking to see if I could see it, get the like regular pricing, but I can't. So you'll just have to use, in my case, the bifocals, and look and see what the tiny prices are so you can see what the regular pricing is. The point in this is just to kind of show you, here's the range of prices. You can look at the details on your own. FreshBooks has a very similar vibe to both Xero and QuickBooks. FreshBooks is more restrictive. As the business owner, there are things that you just can't do. The last time I used FreshBooks, the business owner couldn't make new accounts. So you had to use the prescribed accounts. FreshBooks, I think, is a good solution for people with a consulting business or a creative business. Kind of a very simple, you do some magic behind the scenes, you send your client an invoice, they pay you. I would never recommend FreshBooks for somebody who had like a retail store or that traveled around and fixed things and charged sales tax. I wouldn't recommend it for somebody with like an Etsy shop. So let me just grab a couple more images so you can see stuff. So I like some of this where it's just super easy to see. Like, you don't have 1,000 reports to look through. You're just like, oh, what do I want to click on? I'll click on it. I'll learn some stuff. Next one up on my list is a wave. I tried to get this to show in USD and it didn't. Let me just try it again. Okay, so this one, it won't show up in USD, even though I've searched it, even though I've got my VPN turned on. So you can just search for yourself to see what it is in USD. Wave, I don't use at all. I've tested it a few times and it's certainly an option. It's an option that people like. I don't know any bookkeepers that use it or support it, but I do think it's appropriate to mention, hey, there's this thing and it might be just right for you. One thing to consider is any sort of bookkeeping software that is free runs the risk of just disappearing. So that's something to be concerned with, but not, I mean, it's been around for a while, so I'm not terribly, terribly concerned. I'm more like, oh, you should be cautious. Examples of this are the GoDaddy bookkeeping system, as well as bench.co, but more specifically the GoDaddy bookkeeping system. It was a kind of small, simple bookkeeping platform that one day they just turned it off. Okay, so we take a look at this, the dashboard with the cash flow and the profit and loss. Let's take a look at this. This has got a very similar vibe to what you saw in QuickBooks with the menu on the left, and you can click into the menu and do the things. Here's your list of transactions. That's useful. Let me see what we got here with the colors. So I like this. This is your invoices. So when I'm looking at this, I can see the green is paid and the red is overdue. I like the color coding. The color coding helps me. I imagine that somewhere hidden behind this like fake cell phone, there's a way to filter so you can see just what do I have that's overdue and not necessarily see all the paid. Although the paid is nice, you want to know who to follow up with. The last one I want you to consider, if you're in a position that you're looking for a bookkeeping software and you haven't committed to anything, is Zoho Books. Zoho Books is available in the larger suite called Zoho One. Zoho Books feels very familiar. It feels a lot like QuickBooks, more like QuickBooks than Xero, but like kind of has a QuickBooks vibe, a FreshBooks vibe, a Wave vibe. Here's your pricing. So it goes from 0 to 20 to 50 to 70. You can take a look and see what the differences are. Let me show you Zoho Books. So you got the menu on the left and you have the graph. That's nice. This is an example invoice. The invoice has a kind of a similar setup to all of these where you make the invoice and they indicate what you're selling. You can have some notes. You indicate how many units you're selling and what the price per unit is. With all of these, you're going to have to learn something, but they're also going to have very similar characteristics. Such as this, like you can go to the sales and then look at your invoices. I bet if you look at an earlier screen, there's going to be something that says, here's all your invoices, here's the paid, here's the unpaid, all this good stuff. So a lot of them are going to be real similar. The point of this is just to show you there's more out there than just QuickBooks, even though I only support and teach QuickBooks. I want you to kind of be aware of what's here. I want you to take a look at stuff. If anything looks good or interesting, watch some videos, see how you feel about it. And then if you want to use any of these platforms, if it's not something that I use, just let me know and I'm happy to ask around and see if I can connect you with a bookkeeper. I just need to know what you might need. Do you want a bookkeeper to handle it all? Bookkeeper to get you started? Bookkeeper for training? What can I do for you? All right. Thank you so much.